I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
You called out Miguel Cotto on Twitter a few times. Would you still be willing to go to 54 for the right fight? Could you be a sixth division champ?
I was willing to go out of 154 for Cotto. But I don't see any interest anymore at 154. I mean, my division is obviously lightweight and super lightweight right now, but 154 was interesting enough for Cotto and exciting for Cotto. The name Cotto carried more weight than the division or the title, the championship belt for me. I don't think I'll be going to 54 anytime soon. Maybe way, you know, years from now, you know, if I'm big enough or the right fight at that time, I don't see myself there right now.
Do you see Lipinets as a vulnerable guy, given your style? So a lot of people online are saying that it's going to be a fight where it's going to showcase you. You could potentially get a knockout. Even Lipinets has kind of seen those tweets and tweeted out like, hey, I'm not just going to give this belt over to Mikey. But do you see it kind of going your way like that because of his defense and the way he's come out a little bit damaged in the other fights?
Look, I've seen Lipinets on two occasions, and I don't see it the way most fans or most critics, media, you know, are writing. I think Lipinets is actually a very, very dangerous fight for me. When I consider the size advantages, the strength advantage that he has, those are you know, concerns that I can't ignore. And when he lets his hands go, I mean, he's dangerous. I gotta be careful.
Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best, who? Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future, we don't lose. Tell me what you watching, EsNews. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind, competition, he abusing them.